Alright, so it looks like... Hello, hello, hello! And we are back! So, when we left off, we were facing... What is going on with that? Oh, I see. Okay, that should fix it. When we left off, Jace was having a little bit of problems here with a guard that he was trying to get information from. So, we're going to try again and see if what happens. Cancel! Turn the tide, and... What? No, we're gonna have to draw a new hand. Draw a new hand. I guess we can keep this. Alright, so... What our goal is that this is what's called a discard deck. So, well, not a discard, but a mill deck. Our goal is to actually get him to zero cards. However, I feel as though we're not going to get there if we keep drawing lands. So, two bad draws in a row with this deck that I can't freaking edit. Yep, here we go. Which is fine. Because I cockblock him next turn. Your turn! Alright. So now he won't be able to attack in. And we're going in. Cool thing about this game? Completely free to play. You can buy packs if you'd like, but not necessarily. This attack step. Actually, I'll read this card. Attacks. Now I can race him with no problem. And in the four turns it's gonna take to, the three turns it's gonna take to kill that thing, I'm gonna live. Yeah, oh, is he playing that? Okay. Now we have a little bit of a problem here. Now we can't race as quick as I wanted to. Yeah, this is the right play. Because now we're doing 8 damage a turn. Can't get through. He's gonna be at 10 health now. Okay. probably has some form of instant here. So I'm gonna chump block. Okay. This is how you win with blue. Just completely aggro out. Take 8. How many cards are in his hand? 3? What's the worst that could happen? Some coinage. The rebels are scrappy fighters, but they're no match for you. You best their defenses, pull the location for their planned attack from a tactician's mind, and return to report your findings to Al-Amer. Knowing one side's plans isn't enough. Al-Hamarit needs intel from both sides for a successful arbitration. So you're off again. You run into more troops than you were expecting. Someone important must be visiting the camp, which raises the challenge and the potential reward. Let's see what we got here. Phantasmal. Hey! Okay. So we're just gonna be all up in the air by turn 4. Oh, this is gonna suck. Okay. Like it out, I can race them. Okay, badass. I'm gonna have to skip this attack, then take out that 2-1. because now the deck is about to fly off the hand. Cancel into dragon and divination. Probably the biggest mistake in the game. But now he's got a wall to go through. I could debuff the fuck out of her. Stabilization! What a wonderful thing! make him waste his mana. Right now is just slowly drawing away at him. And we're just gonna do this. He's lost. Mildecking. Is this Alara? Actually, no. Counter 5 spells. Mind grind. In Jace's campaign, when it by defeating her opponent's hybrid. There he is, the mind sculptor as we know. Your duel with Alhamaric shatters both of your minds. In the process, your planeswalker's spark ignites, sending you to the plane of Ravnica, leaving your precious few fragments of your memory intact. As you reassemble your identity, oh, now we're in Ravnica. I thought we were in Ravnica before. Where the fuck were we? Huh, I thought he was born in Ravnica. Okay. Send you to the plane of Ravnica, leaving precious few fragments of your memory intact. As you reassemble your identity, you come to see this plane spanning city as a place you can finally call. So we just ripped Jace. This one. Liliana Vex. You are Liliana Vex. And your corner of the plane, Demeria, is embroiled in a war that has consumed your family. Your studies of healing magic are useful, but the ravages of war draw you to the forbidden arts. After all, why should any tool be off limits in such times? Your brother, Jasu, has returned from the battlefield mortally wounded. Desperate to save him, you are told of a healing potion by the mysterious Raven Mine. But instead of curing him, the potion transforms your brother into an undead horror intent on killing you. Your brother, Jasu, has returned from the battlefield. Oh yeah, okay, so we just read that. Hold on. Okay. Jasu the Cursed. That's kind of cool. Whoa, okay, so we're already going with black magic. That's kind of cool, okay. We can keep this. We're gonna play him first because he's the bigger butt. I like her music too. Kinda all horrifying. Just, it's all very Innistrad-y. But she's not from Innistrad. Like they said, it's Demeria. Oh, we got a lifelinker. Let's see what he does about this first. Okay, so he takes it. So what we're gonna do is play the black cat. Utilize our mana properly. Oh, okay. Man, Bone Splinters is kind of cool, though. Too bad it's a sorcery. If that was an instant, that'd be kind of cool. Yeah, I'll take the two. Cause I know what he's trying to do. Yeah. I know exactly what he's trying to do. Yup. Put out a big dude. Right now it's kind of like pseudo mono black control. Thank you. deck just kind of turned itself. Okay, we've had our fun. Dead. Thank you. That's not gonna be good enough. Is called Innistrad. Here, you embrace the dark magic of necromancy in an effort to conquer death, which came so close to claiming. Brimming with new power, you encounter the home of a hermit witch. The home of a hermit witch, a perfect opportunity to test your abilities. Boom. play Model Black Control. Yeah. Kinda glad we dodged that bullet a little.
Thank you.
Shit. Yeah, you win this one. I fucked up. I was supposed to kill the 5-5. You can tell when... Because that green deck is fucking fast for this format. I could have come back from that, unless I had nudge draws. Alright, so we play first, so we're leading in... Okay. There we go. What's this? Okay. Get a big butt because I do not lie. Swing in for that one. Sweet, sweet damage. I doubt he has Strangle Taste. That was in Innistrad, but I doubt he has a 2-2 haster. 2-1 haster with Undying. No, 2-2. Yeah, I was right. He doesn't have that haster. Now there's three coming at him. I'll skip it for this ability. I'm gonna cheese him out. Done discarding cards for a while. Thank you. Alright, we're gonna have to restart this again. This is actually a very, very hard duel. I'm more than surprised I'm surviving this long. Honestly, this is ridiculous. And hey, we have a viewer. Welcome to the stream. Hope you enjoy yourself. Kick your feet up. Relax. We're all here having a good time. As I say in my description, welcome to being a part of the world's largest couch. No! No backseat gaming! No! I got this. I need a new fucking hand. Oh, fuck you, Deck. Fuck you, Deck. Alright, I got 3 turns in a row to draw into something. Alright, chat. I'm leaving it up to you. Do I ride the one land hand? Because look at this. Shambly Goblin, just 3 of them right there. And then if we draw a land every turn, we can return one of them back and just be a total dick about it. Yes, keep it. Alright, here we go. Gray Fox, man! Ain't it past your old bedtime? I mean, I'm just trying to be lighthearted, but I'm actually glad you're here. Alright, so let's start with the Goblin Rush. That's a great hand. You would think, but we need to draw it to some land. But this is a lot like, I've discovered this is kind of a pseudo control deck. Just this witch guy's got the beats down. Well, right now we're ahead. I blazed through freaking Jace. This is, and also, if you want to know, this is the game you need to play in order to get really good at, like, constructed Magic, in my opinion. This is how I started when I was coming back to Magic, and that's how I got into FNMs. But, oh man, okay. Doesn't matter. Oh, sweet Jesus, thank you. But it doesn't matter, we can just keep swinging it. Just gotta keep that in, because if he blocks that 2-2, yep, 2-2's gone. So now we have to kind of slow down a bit. See what he plays. So, double block. Oh, this bastard. I hate this bastard. Okay. I don't know, chat. Which one should I pick? Agree to disagree. Oh, I see why you're saying that, because then I would have had the 1-1. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, but it doesn't matter. I see where you're coming from, and yeah, that was a correct play too. And I could have gone to kill off a creature and do the extra damage. But right now, this is still a favorable attack. Because the worst that can happen, he's gonna just trade with Gravecrawler, or he's gonna discard a card, in my opinion. And okay, yeah, we got rid of his giant growth, and I don't know why it's doing that. Fuck, he was playing it. Okay. That's fine. I can't do anything about that. Which now he's going to go main phase, play something big. Straight up, we'll just straight up destroy that unblockable, and then bring Grave Titan back to the hand. Grave Digger, sorry. Oh yeah, totally. I missed out on a trigger for that, actually. Yeah, I know about that. I've already had the AI stop to think once. Is this a favorable? Because if he blocks into the... No, it's not. Because I'm not getting rid of it. I don't have the mana to do what I want. Now I do. Or did I? Gab leaving the heart of the cards. Yeah, he's totally playing for the Morbid Trigger, but so will I soon. So, is this a source? Oh. Okay. So let's see here. That's 5 minutes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. One away. Because I want to do, what I want to do next turn is I'm going to Altar's Reap the Goblin. And then play Raise from the Grave on his Fiersterhide board and get a 5/5 with Trample. Yeah, I'm smart like that. But right now, let's go ahead. Oh, fuck. Okay, headphones. Nope. You might think that's a waste, but he's gonna try and pump it. Or he should have tried to pump it. Good on him for not wasting that mana. I don't have enough mana to do what I want. But I can't let him live, so... That's true. I find it funny we're both going for this stupid trigger. Oh! Alright. Hold on. I need to count my mana. 1, 2. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. Trample, Morbid, put four, yeah. Yes. Let me think for myself. I didn't know if I had enough mana. That's exactly what I was planning on doing. Oh, I'm sorry. Now we're in Value City. Alright, let's just go to Cheese City now. Oh well. Alright, sequencing. Yay, sequencing. Boo. Yeah. This is gonna suck. What do you gotta play? Are you an angel deck? Okay. Different simulations with the Jaces. Yeah, I'll take this turn. Cause I'm the idiot. Should've attacked. Thank you. Oh, yeah. I don't think I suck. Just... you're playing decks that aren't necessarily considered good. Oh, I don't have my webcam up. Good. I activated his trap card. Well, no use keeping that around in what? Tell you right now that this deck was good in one form or another in one day, but that day has long since passed. Though for Magic Duels, yeah, this deck is actually bonkers. That's a trap. We're just gonna do this and aggro out. If she thinks of attacking that big guy. No. It's not a favorable trade. She could just eat the 1/1s. See, with this block setup I have right now, I could kill... Oh, I can't actually kill the ox. I could come close. Oh, okay. Let's see here. She doesn't want that cat to die, huh? You know what? I want to see what's in her hand. using that, bitch. Yup, yup, oh, I love Black Cat for that reason in this game. Okay, okay. Yeah, she really does feel like it too. And this is the point where you concede in a normal match. Deserve to die. Angels are nothing more than an annoyance to you. It does not escape you, however, that their attention is a testament to the power you have accumulated. But there's no more time for distractions. Now it's time for the raid. Damn, she's just walking away like, fuck you, girl. Fuck you, bitch. Then we fight Gristlebrand. Oh, she's starting to look more like her cards every fucking picture. You return to the ruins of your family's manor. Before long, your skin begins to tingle. You are being watched. Dozens of eyes, raven eyes, and a flurry of black feathers. A flock of birds merges into the shape of a man, of the man who tricked you into cursing your own brother. She has probably one of the most fleshed out stories ever. Ooh. No, I don't care about you, I care about you. The number of zombies on the battlefield, plus the number of all zombie cards in all graveyards. Yeah, we're keeping this. That might be a game finisher. Hold on. Two target player plus three. cards converted mana cost. Let's see if I can't draw a block out with that. Especially if I draw a card. Yes, yes, yes. Go ahead. Keep doing that, buddy. That's the problem. I can't let that thing swing at me for another big damage. What does he have? Kill it now, then bring it back. Yeah. I like how it's just keeps pumping, but it's destroyed anyway. This is gonna be take a little bit of thought, because here's the thing. Yeah. So here's the problem. You might think I need to kill that 5/5, but I still have one turn to block it. That 4/4 is gonna keep hitting me in the air. Not to mention, but it's gonna die. So I'm. It's a sorcery, so I have to do it now. I He has a disdainful stroke, which I don't know if is in this game or not. I'm in deep trouble. Butcher Ghoul! Okay. Ouch, 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 ouch. Oh, well, good night, Gray Fox. Thank you. doing that, dude. Boom. With your victory at hand, the Raider Man disappears just as he arrived. In a flurry of birds, they scatter in every direction, and you unleash every last bit of dark magic against them. The Raven Man survives, you are spent, and the power you wield begins to take. Decades have passed since your first planeswalk. As you age, you find your necromantic powers cannot stave off the specter of death forever. You become obsessed with preserving your life. No price is too great, and you seek a contract with four ancient demons. There's Bristlebrand. Okay. And across the end. We're gonna have to deal with this. That's okay. Thank you. this might be a couple of reasons. you know what, guys? I'm actually done for the evening. You guys have a great night.